Hi everyone, welcome to this video. In this tutorial, we are going to simulate a very interesting mechanical engineering test, three-point bending. The three-point bending test is one of the most fundamental mechanical tests used to evaluate the flexural properties of materials, especially for structures subjected to bending loads. This test is widely used in material science, structural engineering, and mechanical design because it provides valuable insights into how materials behave under bending stresses. So stick with me till the end for this step-by-step tutorial and let's dive into the world of Abaqus simulation. As usual, we start with a part, but the part we're going to have is something like this. This is from ASTM D7264. We're going to have a part 80 millimeter long, and we would like to have two supports and one load span. Okay, so create part, we name it beam, maybe solid extrusion 200, and we create a rectangle here. This guy must be 4, which is the thickness, and this is 80, which is the length, and the width should be 8. So this is the beam we have. Now it's time to create the supports slash span because we're going to use the same part. This must be discrete rigid solid extrusion 200. We create rectangle. Rectangle must be something like this. This should be 4. This must be 6. And from here, we can create the arc like this. This one must be 2, which is true. Okay, now we need to select this one. And by clicking the scroll button, we can delete the part. And done. This depth must be 8, which is the same as the beam. And now we have a solid part and we want to make it to a shell. So if I activate or deactivate the cut, you see it's bulk and we need to make it hollow. So by left click on this one and hold, we can go through here, create shell from solid, and we select this one and done. So if I cut it once more, we see it is hollow, which means we have a shell here. And the most important part here is to create a reference point. Let's create the reference point. The reference point, I put it here. So in this case, I would define this as a rigid. If you don't define the reference point, you cannot run the job because you get error. But now we don't need to go to the interaction, create the rigid body interaction, and we save lots of time. Now the reference point is created. We need to go to the beam once more, and from here, partition face and sketch, we need to select this face, done, vertical right, this part, and we need to create the distances from this side. This needs to be 8. This one also. And we're done here. Now by left click and hold, we should go to the sweep. Select this one. By holding shift, we select the other one. We click on done, sweep along edge, and we select one of the edges, and we see it's extruded along the. Now we're good to go to the property. We need to create the property of aluminum general density 2.7 E-9, and from mechanical elasticity and elastic 69,000 megapascal, and 0.3 is okay. Now we need to create section 1, continue, material is aluminum, and we need to assign it to this one. This is okay. We don't need to assign any section to the support or span because they are rigid. Okay, we can go to the assembly. We create the assembly here. First, we start with the beam. Now we want to create the span. This is the span. And we can translate the instance from this reference point to here, and now we are going to have the supports. We're using the same part in order to save time for meshing. In this case, we only mesh one of them and it's going to be applied to the all span and support. Let's rotate this one because this is the support. We select these two and 180, enter, done. It's time to translate it. This reference point must go here and done. Let's create another one, another support. We do the same thing, 180, done. And now we want to move this guy to here. Looking at it from side view, you see this is what we have. Okay, let's go to step. Create a step, static general, and as we're going to have large displacement, we need the analgium to be on, and I add three zeros to here to make it 100,000, 0.01, 1e, minus 9, and 0.1 for this one. Okay, this step is done. Let's go to interaction. From here, I need to create an interaction property from the contact. So mechanical tangential behavior penalty 0.15 and mechanical normal behavior, it means to be hard contact. And we need to create the interaction here from step initial general contact, and we have to have the interaction property here. Now we're done with the interaction, we can go to the load. From the load boundary condition, we create displacement and rotation for this one. In the initial step, it needs to be in cast, but in the second step, which is the step one, it needs to displace 8 mm in the opposite of Y direction. And we create one more, this time from in cast. We select this one and this one and done, in cast. Load is over. Now it's time to go to the mesh. So we have to go to part. The support means to be one, and from here assign mesh control. I select all of them and put it on quad medial axis here, and we can mesh this one. Okay, it's not bad. Now let's go to the other part. This means to be one as well. And mesh. Now we look at it in the assembly. So if you look at this one, they mean to be in the same line in order to have an accurate meshing and analysis. Now with the mesh being done, everything is almost over. We need to create the job. We can name it 3-point bending. Continue. Okay. We submit the job and we wait for it to be completed. The job is now finished. Now we can go and take a look at the results. As you see, it bent. Let's put the animation here. Yeah, we can make it slower or faster to see how it goes. The side view. Okay, this is the final thing. If we want to take a look at the curve, we can go to the ODB field output. We put this on unique nodal, RF2 and U2. And from here we can select the first reference point maybe, and we plot it. This is the displacement versus force. As we have only elastic properties, we expect it to be a linear line. Now if we want to operate on XY data, combine U2 and RF2 and we plot this, we see the force versus displacement, and you see here it starts to bend. If we put a value more than 8, this curvature might be more bent, and if we add the mechanical properties, we could have a more accurate result. One more thing we can see here, instead of stress, we can see the displacement, and the displacement here is the largest. That's it. Thanks for watching. If you need the files, just let me know in the comments. And if you want to learn tensile testing simulation, click on the video on the screen before it ends. And don't forget to subscribe to see more. See you in the next one.